I mean, you still got a good relationship with him today?
Me and Suge, cool as a motherfucker. I'm cool with Suge. I'm cool with Master P, Dr. Dre. I'm cool with everybody.
Yeah, I mean, how can you not be cool with Snoop?
But I had to go get that cool with him. I had to go sit down with Suge.
On Crip, that was my nigga. 18 years old, lost in Logan. Crack money had a nigga open, hoping that rap shit wasn't just cap shit. G-Dub, no Drake, okay, that's cool, but that's old news to niggas like us. Cause if so, he would've signed us off top. But bro, stay solid, so I'ma stay solid to that. Studio every night, to the early moan. Bloods and Crips all moving on one accord. Cuz did that, took Death Row to the top. My buzz did that, caught that case, came out safe. Blood did that. So through the ups and the downs, real ones know not to kick niggas when they down. Especially when we was down, that nigga picked niggas up. Gang bang on NY stages, hitting niggas up. Y'all remember that? Yeah, he did some bullshit, I'm admitting that. But coming at a real Crip like he ain't one. Especially when he helped fucking make one on the dead homies. I was at the motherfucking top when I hit my nigga up and said you need to grab pop. Told Daz hook him up, rush straight up out the box. Here's the gang, here's the beats, here's the keys, here's the locks. Yeah, we hit them niggas. Yes, sir. It was us, cuz. Look around, it still is. Just us, cuz. Dre Rich, Nate Gone, and Ricky too. And look at me, shit, I'm about to turn 50 soon. You always said I'd be a star in the game. Now I got a star on the fucking Walk of Fame. I hopped out to see, walked on my star on the fucking Walk of Fame. In that motherfucking Death Row chain.
So, yeah, he did some fucked up shit, but we all human, man. We all got bullshit and skeletons in our closet.
And I didn't fuck with him for that. But now I'm older and I'm in a good place. And when I look back on it,
this man changed my life.
That nigga did a lot of good shit. And I got to get that up. If I didn't get that up, I'll be less than solid.
Let's keep it 1,000. If it wasn't for Suge, there's no Death Row legacy tree. I mean, so I think Snoop was big for that Bygones record. That's huge, man. Plus, he need to hear it. He need to hear it, man. You know, niggas need to. And the people need to hear it. Because it wasn't all bad. And I'm glad he talked about that on the record. It's a big record.
And I hope that record get to Suge so he can see that we really appreciate the greatness that he brought to the table. Everyone wanted to be a part of Death Row. Even I did.
What up, Dre? Dash Corrupt, what up, though? Lady of Range, RBX, DOC. Nate Dogg, rest in peace. Ricky Harris, rest in peace. DJ Warren G. Dr. Dre. City of Compton. City of Long Beach. Death Row record will go down in history, nigga. We did that. Yeah, nigga. We did that. Done.
That was heavy.
You gonna have that nigga in there crying.
You know, motherfucking rock, for real.
You gonna bring him the tears in there.
Shit.
Just make
like
sure he gets it.
Right. He gave it to the dog. That's
bygones be bygones.
That's the name of that.
That's good.
Yeah.
We did that for him.
Right?
And you know what? That's probably all he ever wanted, too.
Yeah, no, shit on.
He just wanted that. Probably didn't know how to get it from you. You know what I mean?
A lot of niggas don't know how to ask for love. Yeah, that's why they say it's a thin line between love and hate. Because I love you so much, I hate you. Because I don't even know how to tell you how much I love you. And all you're really doing is really crying out for love. So that's why sometimes we got to give love as opposed to matching his hate.
Because God bless, if something would have happened to you, it would have broke his heart.